You just got your beautiful new 34-inch ultra-wide monitor. Welcome to the absolute cream of the crop of gaming, productivity, and cinema experiences, my friend. Is what I would have said if Samsung hadn't just grabbed the bar and stretched it with their brand new $1,300 49-inch 32x9 high refresh rate super ultra-wide gaming monitor. But is this thing like totally worth it, man? Or just like totally stupid, man? Speaking of stupid, today's sponsor isn't. The Thermaltake Core P90 tempered glass case features 5mm thick glass, an angled open frame design, different layout options, vertical GPU mounting with riser cable included, and more. Check it out at the link below. The CHG90 is an absolute behemoth. Its 49-inch diagonal quantum dot panel is nearly 4 feet wide, and altogether it weighs 33 pounds. And yet, it still manages to look light and streamlined with thin bezels and a slender yet robust stand with a charcoal and titanium finish that hits that sweet spot between gamery and boring. The 1800R curved screen can swivel up to 15 degrees in either direction, tilt between -2 and 15 degrees, and elevate about 5 inches. So, not nearly as high as it would have to be to support rotating into portrait mode. Sorry, Reddit fanatics, but that is more than a little silly. Flipping around to the back, we find the integrated cable management hook, standard power cable, no brick required, and a cover that pops off, revealing two HDMI 2.0 ports, two DisplayPort 1.3s, one of which is of the mini-me variety, and audio in and out. So all that is actually pretty darn good, but we do wish that the USB hub was a little more 2018 with more ports and maybe a Type-C in there. Oh right, and they also threw in this secret headphone hanger that I'm betting exactly no one will use. The awkward position aside, most people are unlikely to have a desk that is deep enough to spare the extra 3 inches that you would need, given that the monitor's legs already jut out in front of the screen, and the screen itself is so wide that you literally cannot see all of it at once if you sit too close. 28 inches is the minimum that you would need to use this thing comfortably. And even then, you will end up turning your head a little bit to see the start menu and the system tray. Which I guess brings us to the experience of actually using it. In a word, pretty dank. Okay, that's two words. But you could basically think of the 32x9 aspect ratio as kind of like having two 27-inch 16x9 monitors side by side, but without any bezels harshing your vibe. Kind of. In practice, though, a 34-inch ultrawide already feels about as productive as two monitors. This lets you comfortably have three or maybe even four things open side by side if you stretch a bit. It is so wide that it will actually require a little bit of creative thinking to make efficient use of it. Even your 21x9 CinemaScope movies will have black bars on the side. So, I mean, one of the ideas we had was to run a 16x9 game in the middle with streaming and social media windows surrounding it. Cool, right? Speaking of gaming, yes. Just like with a regular ultrawide, support for this resolution can be a little hit or miss, with some games giving you black bars, some zooming in, and some of them working correctly, other than that the HUD ends up so far to the side that it's more like a herd. With that said, when it's good, it's really good. You can have so much of your field of view filled up with screen that it's not that dissimilar to VR goggles, but without the screen door or any controller donglage. And the girthy screen isn't the only perk for gamers. The CHG90 rocks a 144Hz refresh rate, backlight strobing, and FreeSync 2, although it should be noted that strobing can't be used with FreeSync running at the same time. The upside is that Samsung included some shortcut buttons to make toggling between custom display modes easy. So we made one each for FreeSync versus fast response time, and then another with iSaver for working. Now let's have a little chat about one of the other features on the box, HDR. This display claims to support HDR, but as far as we're concerned, it only kind of does. To really give you the HDR effect, any display technology with a backlight needs full array local dimming and a peak brightness of 1,000 nits. This puppy can hit peaks of 600 nits with typical brightness in the 250 to 350 range, which will enhance the look of the few games out there that support HDR, but buyer beware because these HDR-ent monitors are on the rise. Leading us then to the CHG90's biggest weak point, the resolution. It's 3840 by 1080. So compared to 16 by 9 4K, it is half as many pixels, making it easier to drive for your graphics card, but also it's huge and only half the number of pixels. So at this size, you're only getting about 80 pixels per inch, the same as a 34-inch 2560 by 1080 ultrawide at a third of this one's price. Now to be clear, it's not unusable. It just hurts the otherwise futuristic experience. It's like being in a self-driving electric car and going to roll down the window and being like, really? Really? Windows that go like this? Not like this? But I'm not blaming Samsung for any of that because they're limited by what can be done today with the HDMI 2.0 and DisplayPort 1.3 or 1.4 standards over a single cable. So then there are two questions that we have to answer in our conclusion. One, is super ultrawide something that deserves to exist? Well, I would say as long as your desk and the stand are sturdy enough, we're giving it the thumbs up. And number two, should you buy this monitor? That one's a little tougher. It's got a high quality VA panel that's color calibrated right out of the box and offers a gaming and productivity experience that's unlike anything else available today, but the HDMI 2.1 spec is already out. So unless the timing and the price of the CHG90 line up perfectly with your upgrade cycle and your budget, and you really need something today, it might be worth waiting to see how Samsung's competitors super ultra widen the selection in the coming months. Massdrop's back with another simple deal on a complicatedly named product. This is the Massdrop XTHX Achromatic Audio Amplifier 789 Linear Amplifier. It's a linear bipolar amplifier with feed-forward error correction designed for those who can appreciate a clean, transparent amp. It features THX, AAA, and feed-forward topology, which reduces distortion by 20 to 40 decibels for realistic, fatigue-free listening. The chassis is high-grade CNC milled aluminum with a bead-blasted finish, and you can learn more and pick it up on Massdrop today at the link in the video description. Assuming you're a big baller. So thanks for watching, guys. You can dislike or like. You can check out where to buy the stuff that we featured at the links in the video description. You can also get subscribed. You can buy stuff at our merch store. I kind of lost track of how I was doing this outro. Join our community forum.